Hi guys, this is Dr. Zero Amelia, and welcome to the Zero MD Show. Today is the last day of the Hazmat training series. Today is day 6, and it's all about petrol fires or hydrocarbon management. This is Marikit Park here in Olongapo City, and this will be the setting for the drills that will be conducted on how to stop petrochemical fires.
Different technique, different situation. First, we do only with the smoke, like that you can see the smoke go away. After we do with fire, like that you can see the strong of the noses. And after we do a simulation, the gas pipe, we have here a problem, a rescue to do. We put true gas, gas tank down. It's a GPL gas, okay? Without a red apparatus, you can do it. But if you do it properly, it's okay. If you're not properly, maybe you have a problem. Okay? This morning, slowly, higher, like yesterday. Okay?
Yeah.
And after you do another exercise, you can save, you can do a rescue, cut the gas here, and cut the gas to the back. Okay? Similar. And after, I think it's done, okay? Check the two guys, and when you are close to the problem, stop. And after you say, here, okay? We say first step left. Okay, let's go. You want to go away? Say left, left, all the time. Dick. You say my way. Okay. And after, check the two guys and you do what do you want. Drive. And if you want to take somebody.
And that was Christian Decorvey showing us proper technique on how to approach a petrochemical fire or a hydrocarbon emergency and doing a snatch rescue in case there is a victim close to the fire. This is Christian Houseworth leading the first team of firefighters to demonstrate to us the proper technique on approaching and retreating from a petrochemical fire. You can see here how they are going to do a step-by-step procedure in approaching the fire by shouting only one word, just saying left and left and repeating it over and over.
Stop.
This is when he started to say stop, and this will be the fixed point wherein the firefighters will try to maneuver inside a building or an area with petrochemical fire and approach it very carefully using only small steps. In this scenario, Christian Housework and the team approaches an obstruction. So they have to go around it, but they also have to show proper coordination so that nobody gets hurt. Petrochemical fires emit a lot of smoke. So in this simulation, we used a smoke machine to show how hard it is to approach a petrochemical fire with two hoses. As you can see here, the nozzle of the fire hose has to be adjusted so you create a circular area of spray so that the pressure will create a barrier to protect the fireman advancing towards the area with fire. In here, a spine board was used by the instructors to represent a victim below an obstruction seen earlier. Here is Christian Housework dragging the victim or snatching the victim from the obstruction so that the medical personnel at the back can extract the victim from the area. Most of the time, petrochemical or hydrocarbon fires take a long time to extinguish, especially if the source of the fuel cannot be easily shut off. So it is always necessary to retreat from the fire whenever there is a possibility to do so, and then find another angle of approach. We also used an LPG tank to represent a possible source of leaking gas so that we can show how to stop a petrochemical fire using the same technique. We also used the same snatch rescue technique involving small or narrow corridors with only one hose. The same snatch rescue procedure can be seen here using a dummy.
go back to
close
the hole. Okay. We solidate, if possible. We have good solidate. We look in. Yeah. Explore. Yeah. You have to say right. You have to say right.
Another batch of firefighters, this time from Barangay Santa Rita, also performs the same drills as the previous team of firefighters. In this exercise, the group is trying to seal a leaking pipeline so that it stops to emit noxious gas. In this exercise, they will try to shut off a valve that is leaking noxious gas from a tank. Swiss instructor Isabel Voucher is only here to hold the gas instead of being a part of the drill. This group that is involved in this exercise is actually led by the Bataan Bureau of Fire Protection. This is Barangay Councilor Eric Junkie leading the fire rescue team of Santa Rita to do the snatch rescue, which is the same procedure done before. And that is how you handle petrochemical fires as a part of the hazardous materials training. And that also concludes the 6-day training of the Hazmat by the Swiss Fire Department that is done here in the city of Olongapo. However, we still have a few more videos for you if you subscribe to this channel, because next week we will show the accident that happened with Mr. Christian Houseworth of the Swiss Fire Department when he tried to close the LPG tank used in the live fire drills. If you want more updates on when that video will be uploaded on YouTube, make sure to subscribe to my channel. You can do so by clicking on the subscribe button below. Also, you can follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/zeroND and also on Facebook at facebook.com/zeromelia. And that's it for today. I'm Dr. Zero Melia for the Zero ND Show. Thank you very much for watching and mabuhay.